Which one, the bottom one?
This one here is a 12 volt socket.
Yes.
So you could get a 12. If you haven't got any electric and you want to run, you can't run obviously 240 volt appliances, but you can run off say a 12 volt TV or something like that.
Yes.
You could run off that.
Yeah.
But again, you're obviously limited to how much 12 volt you've got in that battery.
Yes.
You go and plug everything and switch everything on. 12 volt battery is not going to last long. Okay.
Yeah.
Right. So your next one I'm going to talk about is your heater. Can, as I said, you just run on electric as well, or gas. You've got another switch there, ultra heat. Do you remember the little switch up the top here that said ultra heat? That is that one there. If you just have a look at the switch up the top here, if you have a look at the control just above the door, that is ultra heat there. See, there's a green light on it. See that? If I switch this switch off here that says ultra heat, that green light will go off. So if you're trying to operate the heating up there,
yes,
and there's no green light on it, it means there's no power.
Yeah.
So you just look in your wardrobe, that switch there, switch it on, you should get a green light on when you turn that one on.
Yeah.
Okay. What that control there is doing is controlling your electric for your fire. Okay, so at the moment it's on 2000 watts, okay, or 2 kilowatts. But if you want to switch it off, it's to the zero, and you've got options of 500 or 1000 watts, or half a kilowatt, 1 kilowatt, 2 kilowatt. Which is heating an element inside there. They are very good.
Yeah.
It's a reasonably sized van, but it still warms up quite nicely.
Very good, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah. You've also got gas operation as well. So if you just want to come down here and have a look. So if you haven't got electric, so this side, sorry, the other side, that is your operating for your gas side of it. Or do I just switch electric off? You don't want to run both at the same time. Right. If I turn that control there. Can you hear it clicking?
Yeah.
That is the igniter, okay? But obviously we need to release the gas, so all we do is just press that and hold that down. You hear it stop clicking now. If I take my finger off it, it should stop, it shouldn't be clicking. If it carries on clicking, that means the gas hasn't lit. But if you want to look down that window, you've got to get it, this window down here, you should be able to see the flame. It's quite a different angle, you've got to try and, so you need the lens rather than the screen. You should be able to see it. Can you see the flame down there?
I can, yes. Yeah. Yes.
Well, if you see the flame, obviously it's working. Okay. The narrow part of the pointer is where you're pointing it to. So obviously 10 is the hottest it's going to be.
Yeah.
Obviously, if you want it, obviously get a bit warm, just turn it down to 2 or 3 or whatever.
Yeah.
Obviously, it depends on what's comfortable, or you just switch it off. In the cold, obviously you've got the option, as I said, electric and gas. If the electric's not getting you very warm, if you fire the gas up for, say, half an hour or so,
yes,
that gas does chuck a lot of heat out. And then,
so in fact, you've got two heaters here.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
built.
Yeah, so you've got
a gas
and electric element at the back there as well.
Yeah.
Okay. So if your electric isn't quite, especially when you first turn up and it's really cold,
yeah,
if you fire the gas up for say half an hour or so,
yeah, really,
and then you can just switch that off. Then turn your electric on, and that will keep it ticking over nicely. So you don't need to use all your gas up.
Yeah.
Okay. This side of it,
mm-hmm,
you see that? You see that? This side of it is your fan, okay?
Just a minute.
All right.
No.
No, right. You think what's the...
I've lost it.
You see, Steven Spielberg doesn't have this trouble, does he?
Yeah.
Right.
No. This is no problem with the lift arm.
Yeah,
that's fine.
Right. So this is control for the fan, okay? The fan will work with either heat. So if you run it on gas, you can have the fan running. If you run it on electric, you can have the fan running. So it actually runs off 12 volts itself. So if you have a look close to the floor down here, there's a vent. You've got one or two vents in the van. There's one near the front, one there, one by the kitchen, and one that would be in the bathroom. Okay, so if you've got the heater running, it's best to have some kind of fan, because that will start pushing the warm air around your van.
Yeah, yeah.
Otherwise, you're just waiting for the radiated heat coming off the fire itself.
Yes.
Okay, center, if you just want to come and have a look at the control again. Center is off, so let's switch the fan off. See that? So center is off. To the left, that's manual. So you can change the control on the top there to a different speed. 4 or 5 obviously is the fastest.
And that's operator and gas and electricity.
Yeah, yeah. And you can actually have the fan running on its own without any heat. So in the summer, it might, hopefully, fingers crossed, it's getting warm.
Yeah.
in the day, you can actually run the fan just to circulate the air if you wanted to. Okay, this side of it is automatic. You see that on the A. automatically that's thermostatic controlled.
Yeah.
So as it when it reaches heat, yeah. it will obviously the fan will slow down.
Yeah.
Okay, so you could set it to the whatever setting you want, and then when it gets to heat, it will you hear the fan
so
die down.
So just to get the electric part of it is switched on up there.
Yeah. You've got the switch in the wardrobe,
yeah.
which switches it on. Yeah. Then you've got the left hand dial.
Yes.
You just
yeah.
which says ultra heat.
Yeah,
which is heater, and then yeah, you just you get the options of 500 watts, 1000 watts, 2000 watts.
Actually, what you know, if you were using, say, you're going away in the winter, you know, so you are putting a heavy load on.